Coming up on this edition of the FGCU Sports Report, we go behind the scenes to find out the secret to the success of the men's and women's soccer teams. The Eagles volleyball team wraps up another fantastic season, and women's basketball coach Carl Smesko and men's coach Andy Enfield stop by to talk about this year's run in the A-Sun. All that and more on this week's FGCU Sports Report.
The FGCU Sports Report is made possible by Mutual of Omaha Bank, matching the right financial service to the right customer at the right time. Mutual of Omaha Bank, your bank every step of the way. And employee-owned Home Tech, serving Southwest Florida for 30 years with service agreements on air conditioning and all major appliances.
Hello, Eagles fans. I'm your host, Tom James, and welcome to another edition of the FGCU Sports Report. Well, the men's and women's soccer teams recently concluded another fantastic season by bringing home what else? Some more A-Sun Championship gold for the Alico Arena trophy cases. And while neither team advanced as far as they had hoped in their first ever NCAA tournament run, they still have a great deal to be proud of, and we salute them. Sports reporter Katie Kaufman takes a look back at another unforgettable season for the men's and women's soccer stars.
In 2010, both men's and women's soccer teams were crowned Atlantic Sun champs. This year, the pressure was on for an encore.
Last year, we had the experience of winning the first Atlantic Sun regular season title, and that group came back with the idea of trying to do more. You know, they want to get to the NCAA and get to the dance.
For senior players, the season started with eyes on their first and last chance for postseason play. Men's head coach Bob Buthorn says that feeling should not be left to the inaugural NCAA eligible squad.
I think that should be a yearly thing. You've got seniors graduating every year that want that postseason taste, so I think the ambition for those guys to do that every year, hopefully it's there. So I don't think there's a pressure to that. Every team every year should feel that.
Both the men's and women's teams finished up their respective regular seasons at the top of the Atlantic Sun Conference and both headed into the postseason as the number one seeds.
Feels good to be number one again, back-to-back champs. It's what we worked for all season.
And Stephanie Powers can definitely feel good. She backstopped the Eagles to their 7-1-1 in-conference record, allowing only one goal in regular season play. The senior goalkeeper also took home big postseason honors. The Sefner, Florida native was unanimously chosen as Defensive Player of the Year. She also earned her fourth all-conference selection. Her regular season 30 career shutouts land her first all-time in the A-Sun record books.
It's kind of funny because you don't play soccer to break the records, but I mean, it's something that just comes along with it. Nothing that I did individually. It's definitely a team effort. The ball has to get past everybody else, and if it doesn't get past them, then it's easy for me to get a shutout.
She's been amazing from day one. She's broken, I think, almost every record this year. You know, she is just such a calming presence for us as a coaching staff, and I would say for our team. As a kid in the back, you know she's super athletic, she's very confident in her ability, and the team just trusts her. I mean, really, there hasn't been a game yet where we played where we felt like that we didn't have the best goalkeeper on the field that day.
The men's team also picked up top postseason accolades. Bob Buthorn earned his second A-Sun Coach of the Year nod, and rookie Xavier Silva was named Freshman of the Year.
I got a text message from my family and my dad saying that we're very proud of you and you make us proud. And just congratulations, and I didn't know what he was talking about, and I called him immediately and he said he didn't know the news that you got Freshman of the Year. So, I mean, it was shocking, but at the same time it felt really, really good.
Silva had a productive freshman season, ranking third in conference for points with 4 goals and 1 assist and 2nd overall in goals and points per game. He also highlights the squad with an A-Sun leading 3 game-winning goals.
I mean, new players, a lot of, I think, 10 or 11 freshmen coming in. It's just about chemistry and about everyone just meshing in and just getting that touch to feel together. And I think that we had that towards the end of the season. We finally just got the groove and just got everything put together.
I'm really proud of him because he came in and he struggled early and really just kept focused on what he was trying to do, and he listened. And he learned that there's a lot that he has to learn. He listened to the older guys, he listened to the coaches, and then he started to realize that a lot of sense came out of what they were saying. And then he just flourished, and he's done very well, and I'm pleased for him, and his attitude is fantastic.
Despite dominating the A-Sun for the second straight year, both teams had their share of struggles.
I think we have had to battle adversity. Like, the Florida game was probably our hardest game to mentally to come back from, and that was when we did go on that long streak. And then the Belmont game, I mean, that was probably the down point, and then we had to come and rise up again, knowing that we're expected to win the A-Sun tournament, and we proved them right.
I think a lot of the strength comes with determination, and I think that's what we had on the field this year.
Thanks, Katie. And as always, you can find the latest news, scores, and highlights for all of FGCU sports at the new and improved FGCUathletics.com, the official site of the FGCU Eagles. For this week's first player profile, we put the sports report eagle eye on women's basketball senior guard Egla Griffin. Let's take a look.
At home, definitely, because of our fans. They give us that extra energy that we needed, like some games when we were lacking it. So that's always a good thing. And they love coming to our games. Some of them even come to the away game, so that's good support for us. I'll go with telekinesis. Like, I guess I prefer that, so I can read my mind, and especially coaches, so that's always good. Never know what he's thinking and what ideas he's coming up with. It's always something new, and what he would say, innovative. Playing with our new teammates, basically seeing what they bring to the table, and hopefully trying to make a run for something this year. I think we have a good bonding. We hang out with each other in the dorms and stuff. We last went, I think it was like 2 weeks ago, we went to see Paranormal Activity 3, so that was scary but exciting, and all of us went, so that was a good little team activity. Besides listening to music, I kind of stay to myself, keep quiet, I don't say much. I kind of put my socks on the same foot, my ankle braces, same foot every time, has to be that ankle brace on that foot.
Carl Smesko is here, women's basketball coach, fresh off of one of the most heart-stopping victories in FGCU history, the thriller over Michigan State the other night. Has your heartbeat returned to normal yet after that one?
Yeah, I may have skipped a few beats at the end of that game, but it was such a great atmosphere at Alico, tremendous crowd support in Southwest Florida. They've always been there for us, and they came out again and, you know, literally came down to the last second, and you know, we just made enough plays to win the game against Michigan State, and it was just a exciting time, and hopefully there'll be more moments like that.
What can you say about the poise of your team down the stretch, giving up a lead and coming back from behind in the second half to win it?
Well, we played a great first half, as well as we've played all year for sure, and developed a pretty good lead, and we were really aggressive attacking, and the second half we got Michigan State, give them credit, they really came out strong, and I thought we got a little tentative and you know, got behind, but the last 5 minutes we started to get really aggressive again, hit some shots, and you know, the last 6 seconds Sarah Hansen took it the length of the floor, got fouled, and made one of the foul shots for the difference in the game, and it was it's just a great win.
What does a win like that over the defending Big Ten regular season champions do for the confidence of this basketball team as you head towards conference play in December?
Well, hopefully it shows them if they follow a game plan and they really play together and play as a team and really compete that they're capable of being a great team. But, you know, I try not to put too much stock in any one game. A couple years ago, we beat Florida in the first game, and we started off really slow in conference play. You take a win, and you treat it like any other game, and you try to learn from it. And I think we did a good job going over tape and looking at some things that we could get better at. And hopefully when we go out the next game, we'll be a little bit better than we were the last game.
You just never know with this team either. It seems like a different player can step up and be the big contributor on any given night.
Yeah, we have a lot of good players, and we have good shooters. And, you know, last week, Nicoya Jackson was the conference player of the week. And then, you know, this game, Chihill starts off hot, and then, you know, Whitney Knight comes in the game and makes some big plays for us, a freshman. And then Sarah Hansen at the all through the game, she kind of made a big play here, a big play there. And at the end of the game, she's got 20 points and 13 or 14 rebounds and just played an outstanding game. But it could be a different person every night.
You talk about Whitney Knight, your freshman guard, a different size guard from anything you've ever had here at FGCU. What kind of what does she bring to the table that maybe you've never had here before?
Well, I mean, she's a very big guard, and she's very athletic, especially for her size. And she's very skilled at the same time. She can handle the ball. She's a very good passer. And in the Michigan State game, she came up big because they were playing a zone where they were really challenging passing lanes in the zone. And our other guards are smaller, and it took them longer to move the ball. And Whitney used her size to move the ball quicker against the zone and helped us get a lot better shots than we were getting when she wasn't on the floor.
Just several games into the season, obviously, and with conference play around the corner, is the team exactly where you want them to be yet, or how close do you think they might be from that point?
No, I mean, we're a long way from being the team that we're capable of being. I mean, the first 20 minutes of the Michigan State game, we looked like a really good team. But we're inconsistent. I think most teams are inconsistent at this point in the year. And you just got to keep learning every day. And it's more about your attitude about progress. If you show up every day and you're understanding that you have things to improve on, I think your team can improve a great deal in a short period of time. And that's what we're hoping to do.
Terrific assistant staff that you have, your basketball coaches, and especially Chelsea Dermeyer, just recognized recently as one of the top assistant coaches in the country. She sure helps out with the staff, I know.
Well, what's really big is, you know, Chelsea played in our program for 3 years. She redshirted and then was our starting point guard for 2 years and was an outstanding player. And then she's been on the staff for a number of years now, and she understands exactly what I want.
Yeah.
And she helps, you know, the new staff and new players, and makes it as smooth a transition for everybody else. But, I mean, she knows the game better than 99% of the coaches in the country. And, you know, she's somebody who's motivated and a good teacher. And we're very fortunate to have her on staff. It's a well-earned recognition that she just received.
All right. Great start, great win over Michigan State, and good luck the rest of the way as you head into the meat of your schedule this
year. Oh, thank you very much. I appreciate it.
You bet. And just a reminder, you can always like the Sports Report on Facebook and tweet us on Twitter and watch the Sports Report 24/7 on YouTube. Just log on to the addresses on the screen and enjoy. Well, although the FGCU volleyball squad ended its season with a disappointing loss to Lipscomb in last week's A-Sun Conference Tournament, this young team finished with a respectable 18-13 record, winning 5 of its last 8 matches. What do the players and coaches think about their performance? Sports reporter Ryan Varanich takes a look back on the ups and downs of the 2011 season.
For FGCU volleyball coach Dave Nichols and his squad, the end of the season isn't just a chance to look back at some of the challenges they faced along the way. It's also a time to reflect on the ways they grew as a result. Even for veterans like senior Holly Youngquist, each new challenge was a chance to shine.
The biggest challenge was probably our home opener here, and there were great teams. We played poorly in front of a big crowd here against USC, and I think that was the biggest challenge, was to get us reorganized and confident again after kind of getting humiliated early in the season. And the girls really responded. We ended up playing much better after that weekend, but it was a tough way to introduce ourselves to our home crowd.
The biggest challenge we had this year is probably relating to injuries. A lot of us got hurt early in the season. I blew out my ankle and I wasn't able to go to the first tournament. And one of our outside hitters has a shoulder problem, and our middle actually went down and broke her foot. So we've been faced with a lot of injury challenges, but we're overcoming them a lot. We're figuring out different ways we can set up things on the court, and it's working out really well.
Determined to bring home an A-Sun championship, the Eagles made sure that before the first serve of the season was even made, they would work hard to get better every day. In spite of a rough stretch of games early on and a rash of injuries, they made good on their promise, leaving Nichols with a smile on his face.
We set the same goal every year, which is make the conference tournament and, of course, win the conference tournament. So that was our main focus. We had one other goal where we pledged to get better every week. And that's been the most pleasant surprise, is we are consistently getting better.
Coming into the season, I think we all had pretty high expectations, and myself, I put an expectation on us of going to the conference tournament, which is one goal that we actually achieved this year, and we're very excited about it.
FGCU volleyball proved to be a resilient bunch this past season. Despite a few early setbacks, the team thrived under pressure on more than one occasion, making for some intense matches throughout the season. None more memorable for Nichols than a mid-September match against Big Ten powerhouse Penn State.
I love when we went out to Penn State, which was a four-time defending national champion, and we win game one in front of 4,000 people, televised game. But that moment was really high-level volleyball in a hostile environment, and only a little while before that we had folded in a home environment against a team that was about the same. So that was a great moment for us, and I think to take a set off that program meant a lot, the growth of this program.
Knowing that where we are right now and where we came from in the past is just a huge step in the right direction. And so I think that that's kind of like the big aha moment for all of us right now.
In spite of falling to Penn State, Nichols believes that matches like those will only help FGCU volleyball in the long run. Playing nationally ranked teams not only gives his team something to measure up to, he thinks it also helps put FGCU volleyball on the map.
There's a lot of reasons we schedule like that. We're trying to improve our national recognition for our recruiting base and also to get better. We want to see how the best programs prepare, how they play, what level we need to get to. And if we do win the conference tournament, that's the type of team you play first round. So for me, the visibility, recruiting, preparation, setting the bar high, only positives come from that.
Thanks, Ryan. And don't forget, you can find the latest news, scores, and upcoming schedules for all of FGCU sports at the revamped FGCUathletics.com, the official site of the FGCU Eagles. For our second player profile, we shine the Sports Report spotlight on women's soccer goalkeeper Stephanie Powers. Take a look.
I'll have no friends and no family that love me, which is totally the opposite of what I have. I get a dog farm. I have a puppy, so I want another one. And then I'll have a whole bunch of puppies. Chocolate. I regret it after, but I just eat a whole bag of Snickers or whatever it is. Snooks. I don't know, she's just a little nugget that you love to, she's just always a ball of fun, and anything she does, it's funny. Twitter. You can follow people and you don't have to be friends with them. Like, I could follow any celebrity that I want, or any rapper, see what new music's coming out. Probably what they're about to do. Fitness, running. I play goalie, so I'd like to keep it in my little 18-yard box and nothing too long distance, running-wise. I think it was sophomore year. I got in trouble 3 times in 2 weeks, and I made the team run.
Men's basketball coach Andy Enfield here with us. Coach, thanks for joining us. And a couple of weeks into the season here, the big thing that sticks out to me about this basketball team that you've put on the floor is how athletic they are and how fun they are to watch this year.
Well, athleticism is a big key in our recruiting. As we build this program, we go forward. You need some athletes on the court. We try to recruit well-rounded players, but as freshmen, we have a lot of freshmen playing for. And they're good athletes. They just need to become better basketball players. So it's a process, and we're excited for them.
So you've played, 4 or 5 games, and now you've kind of gotten the handle on what it's like to be a head coach for the first time. Is it everything you kind of expected it would be? Any surprises?
Well, Tom, it's not a lot different than being an assistant, other than you make the final decisions. Right. It's just basketball, so it's not that complicated. You just have to go out and the end result, you make the final decision, and that's the biggest difference.
You can definitely tell how the fans have really taken to your team and the new look FGCU. And one of the great players to watch has been Brett Comer, your point guard. Not a guy that just distributes the basketball, but he is always also fearless and always willing to take it to the hole and score a lot of points as well.
He's a very important part of our team. He can really get in the lane. He can create for others. He's averaging over 5 assists per game. He's also scoring double figures. He's a huge part of our offense. We just need Brett to keep learning, and the college game is a lot different than the high school game. And as a freshman, he'll have his ups and downs like the rest of the freshmen, But we're excited for him.
And he, coupled with Bernard Thompson, another exciting guy, high-flying guy, has a lot of moves, it seems like. Certainly going to bring a lot to the program as well, Bernard.
Yeah, Bernard is just like Brett. He has a lot of characteristics. They're fearless. They penetrate. They can both shoot the ball. So with that backcourt, we're expecting some good things this year.
Pair of 1-point losses out in the Dallas-Fort Worth area early in the season to TCU and to SMU. Otherwise, you guys would be 4-0 out of the gates. I know those were really tough losses, especially the SMU one. You guys had a big lead and weren't able to hold on. How have the players reacted to that disappointment?
Well, I told him that TCU, we were down most of the game, and we were down double digits. And he said, this is the same team that you were down double digits, and you were good enough to come back. And against SMU, you were good enough to take the double-digit lead, mm-hmm. and then you're the same team that let them come back. So we had 2 tough road games. We had a chance to win both of them in the last minute of the game. I told our players it's all we want. We want to go on the road and have a chance to win. We gave ourselves a chance. We just didn't execute down the stretch, and the other teams had something to do with that.
Throughout the rest of the month of November, you've got another few tough road games coming up, including Miami and Maryland and several others. Do you think that those road games being so close and the fact that they played so tough will help them in these ones to come?
I think so. I think we're done with the fear of being on the road.
Yeah.
We have three games right now this week, Miami, Maryland, and Loyola Baltimore, who's also a good mm-hmm. team. So we have 3 really tough games this week. I don't see you always say between 5 and 10 points you're giving up on the road, and we just have to overcome that. But I don't think our guys are afraid to go on the road now because we've had 2 close games.
You brought in such a great recruiting class, a lot of young guys to go with some of the veterans. How are they playing together and working together, the young guys and the veterans?
Well, we're all new. Coaching staff's new. We have 4 new freshmen. We have a transfer sitting out, and all the upperclassmen. This is new for everyone. But we just told them, we don't care if you're a senior, a junior, sophomore, or freshman. You need to help this team. And whatever role you can create for yourself and the coaches decide, that's what you need to do. And so far they've done that, and we're looking forward to progressing and getting better as a team.
Have you gotten a feeling yet for how good you think this team can be as you progress into the ASUN schedule and beyond that?
I have no idea. I like our competitiveness. I like how hard we play, and I like a lot of things we do well. We have some things to work on, but one thing I can say about this group is they compete, and we can stay around just on our talent level and how hard we play with a lot of teams, and whether we're a better team, that'll be determined. So I'm excited for them, but we have a lot to learn.
Anything about this team surprise you yet that maybe you weren't anticipating from preseason practice?
Well, I think coming out of the gate, I wasn't sure how we'd react on the road. So the two road games at TCU and SMU gave me some optimism that we can go into other people's home court and other teams and really compete against them. So I was really optimistic that this first 2 weeks of the season, and hopefully this week, this will be a big week for us, three straight road games.
All right, best of luck the rest of the way, Coach.
Thanks, Tom.
All right. And don't forget, you can find the latest news, scores, and upcoming schedules for all of FGCU sports at the revamped FGCUathletics.com, the official site of the FGCU Eagles. Well, we are out of time for this month's edition of the FGCU Sports Report. But we have a lot of great sports action coming up in the months ahead, so stay tuned. I'm Tom James. Thanks for watching, and go Eagles!